Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to more Star Wars no bad news. I'm sorry, I keep saying no, it can't be news because it's whenever I want to talk about Star Wars, there's always something negative. I'm kidding. There were news yesterday about a game being cancelled, and hey, I'm all for like when this pops up, I need to know what's going on. Cancelled games in Star Wars? Nah, never happens, bro. I'm gonna read the bit, I'm gonna give my own thoughts. I've heard a little bit about it, but I haven't really like delved into it. Granted, there isn't much text about it. I don't think people really talk about it as much because it wasn't really fully, it was announced, but there's nothing to show for the game that's being cancelled. But yeah, so EA remains committed to a third Star Wars Jedi game. We kind of expected this. This is nothing new. EA announced a major company shakeup that will result in roughly 670 individuals or 5% of its workforce losing their jobs. Following CEO Andrew Wilson's announcement of the cuts today, EA Entertainment President Laura Miel shared a note with staff explaining in more detail what EA's business priorities will be going forward. This includes her announcement that EA is shutting down an early development Star Wars FPS action game as part of an ongoing focus on its own owned brands and supporting its existing games. It's always hard to walk away from a project, and this decision is not a reflection of the team's talent, tenacity, or passion they have for the game. Giving fans the next installment of the iconic franchise that they want is a definition of blockbuster storytelling and the right place to focus. Not much is known about the Star Wars FPS, but it was rumored to feature a Mandalorian protagonist in some way. The fate of EA's Star Wars strategy game is also unclear. EA is undertaking the move in part due to what it perceives to be a rapid shift towards large open world games, massive communities, live service games. IGN understands that the team previously working on this game. Okay. Right, so first of all, look, I know we don't really know much about this Mandalorian FPS game. We just know it was going to be an FPS. You don't expect him to whip out a lightsaber. There's going to be shooting. Also, the idea of FPS, I don't know if I would have liked it as much because, contrary to belief, I love fashion in games. I know I'm very basic myself, but I love fashion in games. And if I can't customize and see my Mandalorian, then what's the point? What's the point of playing a Mandalorian? Granted, Republic Commando did it pretty well because you could actually have, like, you can see how they would see with the masks. But I don't think they would be doing that because that's too much creativity. Fuck off. That's not going to happen. But I will say, it should have probably been a TPS, a third-person shooter. I know TPS is not really, like, seen as something being advertised for games. You don't hear much about TPS. You just usually hear about FPS. So I guess that I get that. And it probably might have also been TPS as well, which is what I would have hoped if it were to release, because I want to customize the armor, the mask. And I guess if you want to go into first person mode, it would be even great if you want to customize your weapon, blaster hold, whatever. If you want to use a fucking carbine or a Gand staff or a Gand stick, whatever you want to call it, or energy staff, that sort of thing. Viral blade, whatever Mandalorian could use to sort of like overtake their enemies. Rocket boosters, fucking everything, bro. Grenades in there, like on the back, on the front. It's like Mandalorian is gonna be the new Edward Kenway, where instead of having four fucking pistols on the chest, got four grenades to throw. Look, the problem that I have with these sort of news is I've been a fan of Star Wars for as long as I can remember. Hell, I don't even know the first Star Wars medium I began with when I was a kid. It must have been probably Star Wars Battlefront 1 from Pandemic, or maybe Dark Forces 2, because I have both games from that time period. I don't know which one I played, but I can safely say I've been enjoying Star Wars game. They're my favorite medium, especially for Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2. The problem that I have is the amount of fucking games that are being cancelled for Star Wars. Now, I get that news for a Star Wars game being cancelled is easier to notice than some other game being cancelled, because that's probably like a one-off story, or it's something that the studio wanted to try out, you know. If a Fable game is being cancelled, which I believe it was, I'm not fully up to date because I don't play them, there will be an uproar, people will complain about it, they will feel sad about it and stuff like that. But it isn't, I feel like it wouldn't be as big of an impact because it's either only happened once or the series was not big enough to fully expand and to fully want a fourth game. Regardless, Star Wars universe is massive. There's so many stories you could tell. There's so many things you could try. There's a lot of things you can experiment. And that's what I love about Star Wars. They experiment with a lot of stuff. You have a whole game of Republic Commander where you're inside a mask. And it's not a clear fucking screen. There's a visor. You could see your health on it. It's being utilized as the UI. And you have a squad team. But that doesn't happen anywhere else as far as I remember with Star Wars. That's it. You have Jedi Outcast and Jedi Academy performing one of the best lightsaber duel fights you can think of. And people still play those to this day. You have Knights of the Old Republic with a massive shift towards story. There is the Lego Star Wars game that are mostly family friendly. And they just pretty much portray the movies in a sort of lighthearted mode. There's experiments in the sense of like they're trying different stuff out. You don't always have the same type of game. It's not always a third person RPG. You know, the one is not open world. For example, Knights of the Old Republic is an open world. Republic Commander is an FPS with team tactics building on. SW Tor is an MMO. That's big enough. Jedi Outcast and stuff like that are pretty much action RPG, I guess, to some sense. You're not really playing your own role, I guess, unless you're playing Academy. But the lightsaber fights are so different, and you don't see this in this day and age. And that's what I love about Star Wars. It just experiments on stuff, and there's so many new things. And the idea, so far, of having a Mandalorian FPS game, the closest thing we have to a Mandalorian FPS is Republic Commando. Which isn't even a Mandalorian, but you have music in that game that has been established as the Mandalorian theme. If anything, if people that play Star Wars The Old Republic and they play Knights of the Fallen Empire or Eternal Throne, I don't know. Midway through that storyline, you go to a planet that is heavily controlled by Mandalorians, I believe, and the fighting droids, if I remember correctly, it's been a while, or maybe Knights of Sakaar, I don't know anymore. It's been so long since I played those stories. But the ambience, the background music is from Republic Commando, and it's kind of seen as the Mandalorian theme, everything of it. But it's the closest thing we have, you know. We don't really have a Mandalorian FPS game. It doesn't exist, and it could have been shifted towards story. It could have mostly been story with some basic gameplay. It could have mostly been gameplay wise with a lackluster story or a medium story. But the universe is so big within Star Wars that it's very hard to fail. And if it were to be canon, it wouldn't be as much of a problem because it's shifted outside of everything else, you know? People wouldn't complain about Knights of the Old Republic, whether it's canon or Legends, because the games are set 4,000 years or about 3,950 years before the fourth movie, A New Hope. Like, no one's gonna bat an eye, no one's gonna care. And if this Mandalorian game, Mandalorians haven't existed since the fucking Clone Wars TV shows and stuff like that. Mandalorians have been existing since that day and age, at least as we know. And that's what I just find weird. Like, this would have been, it would have earned money, especially because the Mandalorian currently is still on the high, and I believe there's a new season coming out. So this would have, I guess, business wise for them, it could have been sort of decent. And honestly, this may sound weird, but a Star Wars game will always, or most likely always sell well because of its IP, of its name. People will buy it regardless. But for me, it's also the fact that it's been so often that games have been cancelled within Star Wars. That's what I think, what I tried to explain with Fable. That it's like, I can't get excited for a game when it comes to Star Wars. It's literally impossible. The remake of Knights of the Old Republic has fully fucked me up. And I've already talked about this in an earlier video. I'll try and remember to link it on the description because I have talked about the game being cancelled. I don't know if it's cancelled now. There's like words in between, like maybe not, maybe yes. But that also pisses me off because I need to have like an idea, like is this game coming out or not? Because I want to be excited for it. But I can't if you don't give me any information about it. Even a simple yes, we're still working on it would have been great. Not a yeah, we can't really get, we can't comment on that because it will make the news. I'm like, of course it will make the news, bro. If you're gonna tell me that you're working on the game or you're not working on the game, it's gonna appear on the news. It's gonna appear on Reddit. It's gonna appear on YouTube videos, TikTok, everything. It doesn't matter. And you saying you were not gonna comment on it still made it to the news. So what point are you gonna try to make? But anyways, aside from that, it's been so often we have Knights of the Old Republic 3 cancelled. We have the Star Wars 1313 game being cancelled. We had another open world game being cancelled a couple years ago. I can't remember which one. But again, there was like one image, I believe in Tatooine or something. It wasn't that grand. The Mandalorian FPS obviously being cancelled now. Battlefront 3 was cancelled, was pretty much 95% done. Also a game that's being cancelled. I grew up with Star Wars games, you know, and I want these Star Wars games to be a great medium for people to experience the universe. But it's very hard because this, I don't know if it's because of the whole Disney ordeal or EA, since they fucking bought the rights and stuff like that. But if I made a comparison, I believe in my previous video that I'm going to link down in the description, the amount of games that were being made behind LucasArts games or whatever they were called, and now is so much less. You know, it's like almost every year you had a game, you know, you had Star Wars Demolition, Jedi Starfighter, Lego Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2, Battlefront 1 and 2, you have the Shadow of the Empire, you had all those Dark Forces games. Listen, I'm gonna go to 15, 20, 30 games being mentioned. And since 2014, we had Lego Star Wars The Force Awakens, the Skywalker Saga Lego game, we had two of the Jedi games, we had two Battlefront games. Did we have anything else? I don't think so. Not that I remember. Maybe it's because my mind currently isn't that on point with the games and stuff like that. But this is the point I'm trying to make. It's like there's barely any games. Like it's been 10 years. It's been 10 years. And we have had almost nothing at all. You know? And that's what's just baffling me. It's like I've been playing so many Star Wars games. Everything is from old because there's nothing new coming out. And it royally actually pisses me off. It does piss me off. And I'm just tired of hearing this sort of news about being cancelled and, oh, we were working on this, but now not. And it's not just with the games, it's also with the TV shows, even though I'm not the biggest fan because there's too many of them coming out for me to follow up lately. But I just hate this sort of news. And I'm sure I'm not alone, but I kind of feel alone because I just don't hear enough people talking about it, but maybe I'm looking in the wrong places. I know that the game wasn't really shown, and to an extent you shouldn't care because you don't know what you're missing because there's nothing to show it for it. But it's still the idea and everything of games from Star Wars being cancelled yet again. It's like it just fucks up my vision for the future, because if there's another game being announced that will come out, I just can't get excited anymore. And that's, I miss the excitement sometimes. I know sometimes you can overhype things. I don't do it to that point because I know overhyping things tend to like make me undervalue the game because of just how much I was waiting for it. And it's not the thing I was, you know, imagining. And my head tends to, you know, think about the biggest things that the game could do. So it's kind of my own fault. So I try to like calm down with that. But I enjoy the excitement. I enjoy the passion, the people talking about it, the speculations, everything. It's just enjoyable because it makes the game feel longer because you kind of play it before it's even out, just with your mind. And then the game is out, you play it, everyone's quiet, and then everyone finishes it and they talk about it and they do New Game Plus or they do whatever, or it's a multiplayer. And it's just, it's honestly such a good experience. But having so many games being cancelled all the time within Star Wars, the IP itself, it just makes me think, if they're gonna do a fucking, I don't know, a Star Wars RPG medium where you could play the game as a Sith warrior during the Sith Wars and stuff like that, whatever. And I'm just there thinking, yeah, that's great, but is it actually gonna come out? Because I don't know. I don't have the expectations for it anymore. So that's just my feeling towards it. It's just sucky. it's like I hate the article itself. I don't know if it's written everywhere else differently, but the whole idea, like, oh yeah, EA remains committed to a third Star Wars Jedi game, and it's hard to walk away. This decision is not a reflection of the team's talent, tenacity, or passion. And that doesn't matter because the higher ups are the ones that have decided to cut it. So what does this sentence doesn't... We don't care about this. I'm sure they had fucking passion. It's a Star Wars project, bro. I'm no game developer. But if I had the chance to work on a game for Star Wars, bro, I'd be hella excited. I don't care, like, how many hours I have to put into this job. I'll do it for the love of it because this is what I love. So this whole idea of trying to, like, control the fire is just weird. And then giving fans the next installment of the iconic franchise they want is the definition of blockbuster storytelling. Yes, we do kind of want to see a sort of end to the game, even though I feel like the game was already pretty much done. Because there's what else can we realistically do with Kyle that doesn't actually fuck up the canon story-wise and makes him impactful? I don't know myself, but we'll see where it goes. But then this whole idea, undertaking the move in part due to what it perceives to be a rapid shift toward large open world games, massive communities, and live service games. Fuck off. Just fuck off. I don't want to hear that shit. Live service games. Get out of here, man. Just make a game, one and done, and that's it. What's up with this live service every fucking time? Massive communities. No shit. It's a massive game. It's gonna have a massive community. Anyways, look, I've never been a big fan of EA. I had my hopes when they were finally, when the DICE was fixing Battlefront 2, and then they pulled the plug when the game was getting good. And it's like, I just don't believe in it. But anyways, I'm gonna shut up now because I've given my point. I'm just gonna move on. I'll try and forget about this. And just... It is what it is, man, because I just can't be asked anymore. I'm just sick and tired of all these cancelled Star Wars games. That's just my opinion. I love Star Wars, man, and I want to experience Star Wars in video game form, and I just never have the chance. The only times I have the chance to do that is if I play old games, and that's pretty much it. But anyways, thank you all for watching my rants. It's been lovely. Stay tuned for the next rant, because I'm sure this whole strategy game will be cancelled at some point. We'll see. To be announced. Okay. Anyways, thank you all for watching. It's been an absolute pleasure. And I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.